The Untold Adventures of Biao, Season 1, Episode 9. Mr. Gong and Biao spent a whole day at the oak tree, but they didn't finish yet. Biao did as his father said. He brought a shovel along to dig a hole in front of the tree, which was struck by lightning that year. The roots of the tree were deep below. Even though the tree was stroked to death by the lightning and mostly burned, its roots were still deep. Biao dug for half a day but still could find anything. He lost his patience. "Dad, I dug for half a day and did not see anything. I'm so tired. It's just a tiny thing, but you cannot do it. Do you really want to study my abilities?" "Okay. Okay, your son is not tired. I can continue digging." But as soon as Biao heard his father's words, Biao continued digging. Because he had asked his father to teach, summoning the dead, for a long time, but his father still did not agree. Digging for a while, Biao found a dark hole under the tree. "Dad, there is a hole down here. You put on the gloves and take out the things inside." "Are you fooling me? There is a snake in it, isn't it?" Biao immediately told Mr. Gong what he saw, but it seemed that Mr. Gong had known it, so he was not surprised. He gave Biao a pair of white gloves to put on and told Biao to take out whatever inside. Biao was just an ordinary person at this time. Thanks to his father that he was a little more courageous than the others. But when he heard his father asked to put his hand in a dark and mysterious hole, he was a bit scared. However, as long as his father was sitting next to him, there was no other way but to do it. Biao had to close his eyes and put his hands to search inside. Biao reached out the courage to search deep inside. Indeed, he felt something round like a watermelon, but there was something spiky as well. Biao didn't care what it was, he just took it out and showed it to Mr. Gong, who sat beside him. "Dad, what is this? It looks so ugly. You idiot. You didn't learn anything. Quickly put it down." Until putting it down that Biao realized that it was the corpse of an old hedgehog. It died years ago and looked horrible. Strangely, its body had not been decomposed at all. The spikes on it were all intact. This was strange. Although it seemed to be dead for a long time, the flesh on its body was entire, except it was sagging and wrinkled. What was even weirder was the hedgehog was holding a snow-white pearl. The pearl was as beautiful as a crystal. It seemed that Mr. Gong already knew what it was at first sight. Being afraid that Biao would accidentally break it, Mr. Gong quickly told him to carefully step aside. He came over to see by himself. "Dad, this is the treasure that you said?" "Yes, it is." "You stay away from me to see it." Mr. Gong checked the hedgehog while telling Biao about the legend of the hedgehog. The other animals create a pearl in their body during cultivation. There is the only hedgehog that uses its spiky body to embrace the pearl itself. So in the old days, it's as known as hedgehog embrace pearl. Furthermore, this hedgehog left the spikes intact, which is a good thing as well. Mr. Gong carefully removed the white pearl from the hedgehog's body, and about 10 spikes were also collected. Mr. Gong took the items, packed them carefully in a bag, and then told Biao to go to the market with him. "Okay, let's go. Let's go to the market." "Go to the market? Dad, we don't have money to go to the market. We have a few coins only. What do you plan to buy in the market?" "Did I say we go to the market to buy things? It's fine to go and see only." Their family was a poor family in Dabing village. They had no fields. They were not allowed to work as a healer anymore. So their lives were quite miserable. After walking for about a mile, they happened to meet a man from the village. When seeing Mr. Gong and Biao, he greeted enthusiastically and asked where they went to. Just in time, this man also went to the market to buy things, so he was willing to give Mr. Gong and Biao a lift to the market. Although the life of Mr. Gong's family was very miserable, Mr. Gong had a very good reputation and good fortune in the village. Biao also understood the situation a bit. He knew that they had a precious snow-white pearl and wanted to sell it for money to have a better life. However, this kind of precious thing should be sold in the city. They should go there instead of a small market. He could not understand the reason behind it at all. Some things couldn't be said in front of the stranger, so Biao could only wait silently on this tricycle and go to the market. They left Da Bing village for about 10 miles to reach Shijiang town. This was quite a big place. The market was always crowded with people, extremely bustling and fun. After saying goodbye to the man, Mr. Gong and Biao went into the market. "Dad, are we just going for a walk like this? There is no need to rush. Just have a walk first. Dad, is Beijing the same here?" "Yes, it's just like this." Biao just had left the village a few times since he was a kid. Such a bustling market like this, of course he never saw before. At that time, he could not stop looking at everything in amazement. In fact, such a market like this could not have many things. There were just a few small stalls selling household goods, farming tools, or animal food. But to Biao, those things that had never been seen before were considered new and interesting. Biao walked and looked, suddenly saw a figure of a girl. It was Zan Ni. It turned out that little girl Zan Ni brought vegetables to the market. Biao thought that if there were no other family members, he could talk to Zan Ni more. So he approached and greeted her. They just started the conversation, and Biao was about to respond. However, he did not expect that his flirting plan this time would be ruined by his father. "Let's go. There is still the business to do. Zan Ni, I still have something to do. I will find you later." Of course, Biao didn't want to leave at all. He walked with his father while asking for excuses. "Dad, after all, where do you want to go? I'm hungry. You just want to find Zan Ni. This trick doesn't work. Dad, I'm really starving. I'm not lying to you." They walked for half an hour, just as Biao lost his patience when Mr. Gong finally found out what he looked for and stopped walking. There was a blind old man in front of them. This blind man's ears were very hearing. He was both dealing with an elder who was having fortune-telling and spoke to Mr. Gong at the same time. Mr. Gong ignored Biao, turned his back to follow the fortune-teller. "The lines in your palm are not clear. Your destiny must be disrupted by a bad guy. You blindy, do you deceive people again?" Hearing the voice, Mr. Gong must have come. "You also take little Biao along as well. Looks like I have wine to drink today. All right, if you go back and adjust the head of the bed in this direction, it will be fine." It seemed that Mr. Gong was very familiar with that blind old man. There was no such thing as formal at all. Just met, he took a seat in front of the blind man and said unclear things. "In the morning, my left eye was already twitching. I knew there would be good things. Stop bullshit. Mountain exploit to find treasure. You haven't exploited the mountain for such a long time. It hasn't been good these days. There is no way else." It looked like Mr. Gong and the blind man had fortune-telling. But when Mr. Gong and the blind man both stretched their sleeves and shook hands, seeing that, Biao knew that his father was using gesture language. This was a particular way of trading in the black markets. There were not many people who knew how to use it anymore. For a while, only seeing the blind man's mouth mumbling something and suddenly laughing, seeming he discovered something. "So what? Will you treat me, or will I treat you?" "All right, all right. Let's me treat you." Blind old Lu led the way. The three of them turned around and around and entered a very bustling restaurant in the town. They ordered four dishes and white wine.